Do you know that 90% of information transmitted to our brain is visual? A study conducted by an internet marketing agency shows that high quality infographics are 30 times more likely to be read than text articles. Should we then include infographics elements as part of our slide design? Hi again, I'm Tian Teck with Sticky Spy. In this video, I'm going to talk about infographics and how it can increase the effectiveness of your visual communication. Welcome to another episode of Amazing Sticky Presentation inspired by Sticky Spy, bringing you tips, ideas, design for better presentation, turning your ideas into lasting impressions. More and more, we are seeing infographics being used in our daily lives. May it be in the news, in magazines, in technical journals, in reports, or in presentations. We see them every day in different forms and formats. Because our brains prefer seeing visual elements, we are likely to pay more attention to a page or a poster that includes pictures or graphic or illustration of some sort. Adding visual elements to represent words or data makes information comes alive. It also means that something boring can be made interesting. So, what actually is infographics? Well, the definition of infographic is visual storytelling plus data presentation. Information transformed into graphic elements that tells a story, and along with it, we include key data that can be shown clearly. There are many purposes of infographics. We can use infographics for visualization of a story, to educate and inform, or to communicate an idea or brand. Of course, there are good and there are bad infographics. To design good infographics, we must first understand some aspect of visual design so that we know how to apply the principles of design when creating infographics and its elements. Among the things that we need to know are things like the use of white space, effects of font sizes, color harmony, contrast against other visual elements, etc. If we do not understand visual design, we can very quickly create bad infographics that are confusing, like this. There are many different types of graphic tools available to create infographics. One of the very popular online tools is Canva. However, we don't need special software to design infographics. PowerPoint or Keynote alone can do the job. To design infographics for presentation slides, we must also follow the principle of simplicity. Everything that you learn about designing good presentation slides applies to infographics too if you are using them for your presentation slides. Here is an example of a PowerPoint slide with infographics elements. All those infographic elements that you see here was created in PowerPoint using combination of shapes. If you are still watching, how about giving this video a like and consider subscribing to this channel for more videos like this. Now, let's see a quick example of how this can be done in PowerPoint. I'm going to create the man that you see here in this slide. First, I will insert a blank slide. Then go to Shape, select the oval shape to first create the circle for the head. Next, I will use the rounded rectangle shape to create the hands. Then duplicate the rounded rectangle and reshape it for the body and legs. Arrange all the three shapes and group them together. Here you go. Infographics element of a man. With this, we can easily make more copies of the man, change to any color we like, or resize it. Other elements in these examples are the burger, clock, bentos, and sandwich. Most of what you see here are simple elements. Here is another example of a slide with data and infographics elements in use. I call this format Infographics Data Dashboard. Of course, with more advanced techniques, you can also create complex elements with more details, like the plane, a ship, and more realistic elements like this guy doing a jumping jack, all done in PowerPoint and Keynote software. I hope this short video gives you an idea on how to start creating infographics elements with PowerPoint and use it in your presentation slides to improve your visual communication. Do you use infographics for your presentations? Do you create infographics elements with PowerPoint or use ready-made elements? Let me know in the comments below. I would love to hear from you on how you use infographics for your presentations. Until my next video, if you are new to infographics, try creating one with PowerPoint or Keynote using combination of shapes. It's not too difficult. You'll be surprised how much better your slides will look when you add infographics elements to it. Bye-bye.